Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this dissection supplementary video, we're going to be discussing the arteries that we need to be able to identify for the anterior neck and thorax session. And we're going to start with the thoracoacromial artery. And this is more the view that we will see in this particular session. But I did want to kind of talk through this image right here to kind of give you an idea of where the thoracoacromial artery will originate. And this will be all the way in this axillary region with the very aptly named axillary artery. And it's going to have numerous branches all over the place, and we'll get into these more when we get to the musculoskeletal section. But I do want to note this branch right here, the short trunk from the second part of the axillary artery is the thoracoacromial artery. And from this trunk, you will have branches extending kind of all over the place in this region. You'll have pectoral branches, you'll have deltoid branches, you'll have some axillary branches. But the ones that we're most focused on are going to be the pectoral branches of the thoracoacromial. And you will see these as part of the neurovascular bundles associated with the medial and lateral pectoral nerves. So we're looking kind of where the lateral pectoral nerve would be, and you can see a bit of the thoracoacromial artery or a branch of it, and it'll extend into this the regions over here. So it'll come in on this deep side of the pectoralis major with the neurovascular bundle, and you will have some supply to the pectoralis minor as well. Again, in these neurovascular bundles, in an assessment format, we would ask you to identify the nerve, or we would ask you to identify the artery or the vein. We wouldn't ask you to discuss all three. Okay, now we're moving into the neck region, and there is going to be a very large artery that's associated with the lateral neck, and this will be the common carotid artery. And again, this is running right down this portion of the neck on either side, and it will be part of the contents of the carotid sheath. So you see this internal jugular vein right here. The common carotid will be the more medial, and then the vagus nerve will be deep and intermediate. And the common carotid is not going to have any branches in this area. It's not till we get up to its bifurcation point. And it's going to bifurcate into its two terminal branches, the external carotid and the internal carotid. And there's two distinct differences, or there's one main distinct difference that you're going to be able to tell which one is which in this area. The internal carotid artery has no branches in the neck. So if you have an artery in this region that is one of the two terminal branches of the common carotid, you're looking at the internal carotid. Whereas the external carotid is going to have numerous branches, which you can see kind of all over this region here. So the external carotid will have the branches in the neck. And one of those branches will be the superior thyroid artery, which you can see heading descending to the superior portion of the thyroid gland. And it is unique in the other external carotid artery branches in that it's the only one that will descend. The rest will ascend or move transversely. It does give off a small branch that we'll talk more about in the larynx session called the superior laryngeal artery, which you can see right there. But this right here is going to be the superior thyroid. You can see the superior thyroid artery here coming off the external carotid. And you have a really nice view of it heading towards the top portion or the superior portion of the thyroid gland. Much more to come on this internal carotid artery, particularly when we get to the brain, because it's going to be one of the two major suppliers of the brain. If you have a superior thyroid artery, that's a good indication that you're going to have another type, and that's going to be the inferior thyroid artery. This is actually going to be a branch from the thyrocervical trunk of the subclavian artery. So this large artery right here is the subclavian. The subclavian will eventually kind of continue on this way and change its name to the axillary, which is that artery that we saw previously. So right here you have this thyrocervical trunk, and it will give off numerous branches, but the one that we're going to care about right now is going to be the inferior thyroid artery that is going to dive kind of underneath the common carotid right here in order to get to the thyroid gland, and this is your thyroid right here. All right, so that should wrap us up in terms of the arteries we're going to identify today. And so a lot of these are telling you kind of exactly where they're going to go. And we will review some of these in subsequent sessions as they kind of come up over and over again throughout our dissections. Thank you for your time and attention here, and have a great rest of your day.